As far as the applications are considered, organochromium compounds, that is chromium 2 oxidation state reagents, they are very powerful electron reducing agents. Now, chromium 2, it readily inserts into allyl, alkynyl, alkynyl, propargyl and aryl halides. And it also sulfonates under aprotic conditions, giving rise to the corresponding organochromium in oxidation state 3 reagents. Some amount of nickel salts bring about a catalytic effect on the formation of carbon chromium, where chromium is in oxidation state 3 bonds. So as far as our first application is considered, it is Nozaki-Hyama-Kishi reaction. So this reaction, that is NHK reaction, chromium chloride adds to unsaturated halides to form organochromium compound where chromium is in oxidation state 3, which are used as nucleophiles for coupling with aldehydes. For reactive substrates such as alkynyl and aryl halides, doping chromium chloride with catalytic amount of nickel or manganese, this gives very good results. And the carrying force or the forwarding force for these reactions is the formation of a highly stable oxygen chromium bond in which chromium is in oxidation state 3. So here are the various steps that are shown for NHK reaction. In step 1, you can see nickel from oxidation state 2 gets converted to oxidation state 0 in the presence of chromium, which itself gets changed from oxidation state 2 to oxidation state 3. Thereby, nickel in 0 oxidation state comes in contact with alkyl halide and insertion takes place. Nickel insertion takes place. Further, this compound reacts with chromium 3 oxidation state and now nickel is replaced by chromium. This organochromium halide comes in contact with ketone and forms a complex compound, an adduct, with oxygen chromium bond which is introduced here. This oxygen chromium halide on protonation gives alcohol and so on and so forth, the cycle continues. The same reaction I have also shown in the cyclic manner, so you can very well coordinate both the steps.